played our dues.
We want Garcia, man.
We done played our rules.
Yeah.
We paid our dues.
The Bay Area, we got a lot of talented boxers. Andre Ward, Karim Mayfield. Are you familiar with some of the fighters up there?
Yep.
What can you tell me about them?
Mayfield out of Fillmore. Ward out of Oakland. Both doing their thing. Shout out to both of them, man.
Karim raps too. You know that, right?
I didn't know he rapped.
Yeah, he got skills.
I know his cousin Laron. Shout out to Laron.
Hey, I'd like to say hello to everybody. It's Antonio Leonard with Antonio Leonard Production. I want to talk about my man, Karim Mayfield. I think he's one of the most exciting young fighters coming up. As I understand, he ranked number 2 by the WBO and number 4 by the WBA. He's very exciting. He's from the Bay Area. And I mean, he's like one of the up-and-coming. He's going to be one of the top welterweight fighters out there in the world.
You mentioned right after the fight, Karim Mayfield. Did you talk to him at all? Or?
Yes, I heard from Karim Mayfield's people. They definitely want to fight. And the reason I said Karim Mayfield was because Mayfield is a guy who I know will fight Paul. Mayfield ain't scared to fight nobody. Mayfield ain't giving a care. Mayfield will fight you. He don't care what it is. You understand me? So Paul say he want to fight one of the best. Karim Mayfield is one of the best at 140 right now.
Your boy Karim Hard Hitter Mayfield. Middle name Rashid. Karim Rashid Mayfield. And, I started off as a young street fighter. You know, I had a lot of names coming up in Fillmore. Yeah, my first one was Elephant. OGs call me Elephant. They would say, you know, I was a little stalky little dude. And they would be like, yo, watch this young dude do 100 push-ups for $1. They'd be like, little Elephant, come here. And I'd be like, what's up, man? You know, stubby, probably about 6 years old, 5, 6 years old. Man, knock out 100 for me right quick. And I knock out 100 push-ups. Growing up in Fillmore, we always... Everybody would fight, you know, we say chuck them, everybody would chuck them, you know. And from a youngster, we were slap boxing. Everybody was slap boxing. You probably had about 3 or 4 slap boxing, damn near fights every day, you know. Every day you was going outside, it was going to be a new challenge, you know what I mean. And then we actually started getting gloves in the hood, and everybody started going with gloves, man. So, you know, I didn't have that many amateur fights as an amateur, but those block fights is definitely, you can count them as amateur fights.
I mean, they asking who is Karim Mayfield. Danny Garcia act like he don't know me. Man, he know who I am, man. They flew me out to Philly to give him some sparring to get ready for Eric Morales, man. What's so crazy about that, about a month prior to that, we was right here out in the hood, though. We made a video calling the cat out before he had any titles, you know what I mean?
Hey, we in Fillmore, California, man. Hard hitter Mayfield, man. We in the building, man. We knocking these suckers out, man. They all got to go. You dig?
You did.
Fillmore, California, man. San Francisco. Dig that.
Mm-hmm. Hey, left hook to your body. Watch me quiver with your liver. I wear the iced out UPS chain, homie, because I deliver. I'm a knockout king. Danny Garcia, you get knocked out green.
Yeah.
You're scared when you hear that ding, ding, ding. Mm. I guess you heard that my hits, they drop like bombs. My heart and skills from my mom and my brother Laron. I'm K still hard hitter while the rest of y'all suck. My hands is dogs with no name, so I can't call them off. I'm bobbing and weaving. Other dudes slobbing and bleeding. Ooh. When get the chance from the refs to be robbing and cheating. Uh-huh. I said I'm roaring like three divisions. Yeah. I don't win by decision, I win by collision. My hands ready to get loose like thugs in prison. Uh-huh. When I step in the ring, ain't no disses and mean mugs. But when the bell rings, it's fists and mean slugs. Dad's a racist, calling Kendall Hall a monkin. But I'ma leave you drillers, sloppy, drunken. I'm a gorilla in the mist with my fists to your pumpkin. Bitch, bitch, bitch.
God. And Cass is asking, how do we have the audacity to go in? For one, man, we've been fighting undefeated cats, man. We've been fighting dudes, the promoters, fighters, you know what I mean? And they told me from the beginning, we'll sign you if you beat our guy. This has happened like 6 times. Before I was even 10-0, I swear I fighting for like 5 or 6 undefeated cats. That was up and coming prospects. You know what I mean?
He coming in as an opponent, man.
Every
first
time.
Of all, man, we coming from the ground up, you know what I mean? And they, each of these promoters, they come get Karim to be the opponent for their fighter. What Karim do? He end up knocking their ass out.
Man, they all gotta go, man. 5-0, you dig? 2 or more, man. SFC,
get it, yarrah. You know what I mean? We got another win, my man. You gave me, man. Man, I mean, Don King, he know what it is, man. Mo better, Mo cheddar, man. Straight to the top, Karim Mayfield, hard hitter, man.
They asked me, Dan Goosen asked me to fight up. His kid, Francisco Santana, he was undefeated. I was undefeated. It was a Showtime bout. I had it was a televised bout. I had the man's rest in peace, Angelo Dundee, in my corner. I had The Rock winning. You know what I mean? I ended up fighting. It was a good fight. I won a decision, split decision. They say, Karim, we need a rematch. We assign you if you fighting for the rematch. I'm like, I ain't got nothing to prove. I don't need no rematch. But they talking about signing me, let's do it.
Karim just scored a knockdown over the man who has beaten before, and it looks like he's beating him again. Karim Mayfield moves to 11-0 with a knockout victory over Francisco Santana.
I was fighting, you know, a lot of these prospects, man, and getting short few weeks notice, man, you know, and these dudes been training for 6-8 weeks, you know, and they'd call me 2 weeks notice, and I wouldn't get no fight, so it's like, man, I was hungry. I'm like, man, and I was ready to fight for the most part because the money wasn't nothing back then, you know. You get a few stacks, if that, you know what I mean, for a 4-round fight, 6-round fight, but I just wanted to fight, you know. You know, I wasn't having no fights. I didn't fight for almost a year for one good spread of time, and my big brother been throwing promoting parties and stuff or whatever in the Bay Area.
More Better Entertainment presents the world's first 7th annual Aquarius Bash. Saturday, February 9th, the all-white party at Yoshi San Fran, starring the K. And we're also bringing Kareem Hard Hitter Mayfield for the all-white affair. Optional theme attire, upscale attire required for this event that will sell out, with music by Mind Motion.
You know, so he was just like, Reem, man, let's put something together. You know, I didn't have a promoter there. He like, let's put a show together, you know. So we came together with this promoter called Hard Knocks Feel Tomorrow. I mean, a lot of people was like, oh, no, nah, y'all shouldn't throw no show because it's going to be, you know, you need a bigger fan base or something. But I felt I had the block behind me. I felt I had the city behind me. I felt like I had the Bay behind me.
San Quentin, baby, steady coming steady with jams. Coming, steady so tighten coming. Up on your game,
please,
folks.
Believe it.
The place we claim is the West Coast.
I can go back and recall that I also managed to promote Andre Ward. And we had a fight out here in the Bay Area. And Mr. Mayfield did a fight out in San Francisco. And I'm telling you, it was one of the most amazing things I've seen. I mean, I never seen a fight that I went to where the whole crowd anticipated after Karim knocked this guy out. I mean, it was unbelievable. But I can definitely tell you that, look out for Karim in 2013. I can guarantee you that he will become world champion.
I gotta ask you this. How did it end up that your guy, Karim Mayfield, end up sparring with Manny Pacquiao? Tell me about that. How did they approach you guys?
Oh man, you know, it was automatic. You know what I'm saying? The perfect person to prepare Manny Pacquiao for a Sugar Shine, Karim Mayfield.
You know what I mean? Up top. I put on for the city though, man.
Downtown.
Still in Harlem, man. Yeah. It's that LA for city though. I put on for that chat at all. Like Rhonda's more better, hoe living good, living better though. I'm 50 more, where we hustle and get the dough. Leave your f around and my homies gon' pimp it all. I'm an ASAP minor. A real big time up. You haters just minor. Just Mac is the time up. So fuck out.
It's a no-brainer that Karim has been run out of several camps because, you know, he's given the champions problem. That's not hearsay, that's true talk.
During training camp, many things come out to the media that are not necessarily true. It was reported recently that Karim Mayfield stopped being Manny's sparring partner because of headbutts. Well, Freddie Roach says that's not exactly the case.
Karim Mayfield, he's done sparring me. Yesterday was his last day because he hit a little visiting. Mayfield did a great job.
Now, he is a southpaw, which is no big deal to you, because the reason you even are back on the fight world radar is because, well, you've been sparring against one of the best southpaws in the business, Manny Pacquiao. And tell people what happened when you went down and started sparring with Manny Pacquiao down in Hollywood.
Oh, man, overall, that was a good look. Just great experience. I mean, the exposure was great. And I learned a whole lot. So, you know, after seeing something from Manny Pacquiao and the speed and the power from him, you know, I'm ready to go after Superman if he was a southpaw.
And Ryan, the going down there was a great move for him in terms of being able to get back into the game as well, wasn't it?
Oh, definitely. Being able to sign with Prize Fight Promotions, which is a Mississippi-based promotional company, it's been able to get him on the map.
I'm here with boxing star Karim Mayfield to talk about Manny Pacquiao, Shane Mosley, and his next fight. Karim Mayfield, when's your next fight?
June 17th, ESPN. Check it out against Stevie Forbes.
You're always the major underdog. How are you going to pull this one off?
Man, I'm going to pull it off with a strong, victorious fight. SFGG don't stand for San Francisco Golden Gate. It stands for Steve Forbes Gotta Go. So that's my motto for the next fight. Steve Forbes Gotta Go.
Steve Forbes is impossible to knock out. And understand, he has faced some of the stiffest competition in the sport. He faced Oscar De La Hoya years ago. De La Hoya was unable to stop him. De La Hoya won the fight, but Forbes, who is a former super featherweight champion many years ago, Steve Forbes was able to go the distance. Forbes fought Andre Berto. Steve Forbes again against Berto, who has explosive punching power, was able to go the distance. As it is, he's never been stopped. He's never been stopped.
Forbes, early in his career, uses feet, making
it a right hand.
He gets caught again with the right hand. Again, he lunges, leans forward, and he's in trouble.
He's trying to survive. A series of punches from the unbeaten Mayfield. On the attack, and this fight is over. TKO victory, Karim Mayfield.
I said it earlier, you saw Mayfield doing a little bit more work.
Karim, hard hitter. We appreciate you coming by. Thanks for spending some time.
Thanks.
Good luck.
I know
you're off to Mississippi tomorrow.
I am.
Best of luck in the fight with Patrick Lopez. Bring that belt on back to San Francisco.
It's coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, prize fight and Bo Betta proudly present this NABO Junior Welterweight Championship. This is the main event.
Come on, we're talking about an NABO Junior Welterweight Championship on the line. Mayfield with a big right here as we start off the fourth with some fireworks.
Yeah. And Lopez's glove came close to touching right there, and Phillips is right on top of it watching. Mayfield does not let you breathe, Greg. He stays on you the whole fight.
Well, Mayfield smells blood, and he's going right after that cut.
Big right hand again from Mayfield. Nothing behind it. There's another right hand.
And Lopez goes down, and he's frustrated. The first punch, it looked like Lopez said, hey, it didn't hurt me. And by the time he got it out of his mouth, Mayfield made him back. Mayfield was too quick a fighter to mess around.
You gotta protect yourself at all times. There's another right hand.
And Lopez quickly back on his feet. But he showed that so far.
Oh, big right hand.
Down goes Lopez.
The winner and new NABO Junior Welterweight Championship, Karim Hard Hitter Mayfield.
You know, my mom and my grandmother always emphasized, being creative, using your inner creativity. You know, you can't count on one source for income. I was a little older, she would say MSI, and we always go by MSI, multiple sources of income. Because having one is too close to having none, you dig?
A wonderful piece for us called Growing Old Gracefully. Everybody, here they are, really make it loud for Karim and Shonda. Come on, y'all. Come on.
You know what happened to me last week? I ain't even tell you. I be forgetting so goddamn much. I'm driving. It's two lanes, and I couldn't get over. I'm wondering why I can't get over. I finally get over after a damn near an hour I get over, and I pull to the side, and I see why I couldn't get over. This man driving slow. I pull around the side of this man. It's an old Chinese man with glasses, Texan. Why driving? Am I going with this old Texan? He older than me, Texan.
That's why you couldn't get over.
I couldn't get over. No. Anyway, I pull over. I'm mad by then. I pull on the side. I'm like, damn, sir, you pull over. Pull up, come over. He raised down the window, smiling, and said, fuck are you?
Oh, he was mad about it.
He was about it. I said, fuck are me? Fuck are me? You pull your ass over. Pull the fuck over. He said, yes, Daniel, son. Pull over.
Oh, he was ready.
That motherfucker told me to pull over.
Oh, he was ready.
I started thinking, okay, I had a long day. He's an older man. I don't want to, fuck it. I just kept driving. I kept driving.
So you just kept it moving?
I kept moving, and I'm about a half a mile down. That motherfucker's still in my rear view. You talking about pull her over? Pull over!
So you got punked then, Charlie. You let him punk you, Charlie.
The kind of fight that serves a purpose in the sport. Junior welters, unbeaten prospects, beating up Karim Mayfield, Tito Serrano. Mayfield started getting the best of him in the third, Teddy.
Yeah, well, his right hand is a power punch, and he found out early he could land it.
Things got real interesting at the end of round four. Right on the bell, picture-perfect right hand from Karim Mayfield.
Yeah, that's his power punch. He lands it clean, but watch the little subtlety here on this next replay. He dips a little bit to his left, dips low, and then he loops high. And that takes the eyes away from Serrano. Serrano never saw that punch. Watch again. He dips a little bit, then loops high. A clean punch, a blind punch. Serrano never saw it. He never got really properly taken care of in that corner. Got no ice on him, no water on him.
Right here, we got all these beautiful houses and Victorians and million-dollar houses, multi-million-dollar houses.
And right down the street, you got the projects. It's like, this has always been crazy to me, man.
You know, we lost a lot of people in these streets of Fillmore, man. A lot of our partners died, man. You know, I got a whole bunch of obituaries. These just a couple right here, you know. A couple of homies that didn't pass, you know what I mean? Then got killed. You know what I mean, right here. Matter of fact, that's one of the homies, Keese. He got killed. You see right here, look, this is the police department right here. San Francisco Police Department, right? And he got killed right here. See this McDonald's right here? Right in front, right here. The only thing the police gotta do is run out the back door, it's so close. You know what I mean? This shit's really real out here, man. This ain't no game, you know?
Light welterweight contender Mauricio Herrera backs down from no one and takes on lightning-fast American Karim Mayfield, looking to continue his ascent. Boxing After Dark.
Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white with red stripe, weighing in at 139 pounds, with a record of 18 wins, 2 losses, 7 wins, coming by way of knockout from Riverside, California, currently ranked number 7 in the world by the IBF. Please welcome Mauricio, El Maestro Herrera. And his opponent fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black with red. He weighed in at 140 pounds. He is undefeated with a record of 16 wins, no losses, 1 draw, 10 wins, coming by way of knockout from San Francisco, California, ranked number 6 in the world by the WBO and WBA, the current and defending NABO junior welterweight champion, he is Karim Hard Hitta
in. Final 4 seconds of round seven. Left hand from Mayfield.
Basically, Mayfield landing this straight or kind of overhand right, over and over again, right on the top of his jab, because Herrera comes in with his left hand down. Once again, there the right hand is on the top. There it is again on the top. There's three times the same thing, straight right knee right there.
You know what I noticed there? Punches. Oh, round eight comes out. Mayfield opens up.
Smothering Herrera on the inside, not giving him room to punch or throw big punches.
Oh, another right hand and another right hand from Mayfield. Herrera tries to fight back.
How many of those can Herrera take?
Big power shots landed by Mayfield in this round.
Oh, he's weaker than two punches.
Wow, big shots landed by both.
Yeah, finally, I think he hurt Herrera on that time.
Definitely started from the bottom, man. And we up. Yes, up. WBO, number two in the world. You got these cats talking. He ain't even ranked in the top 10.
He ain't getting a shot.
In the top 10 first.
He ain't doing
it. In the top 10 first.
It's now in the third. I'm number two, WBO, right behind Rios, who about to fight Pacquiao. You know what I mean? He number one. I'm number two. I'm number four, WBA, right behind Amir Khan that might be probably fighting Mayweather.
Come on.
So, hey, come on, man. We definitely rate this.
Y'all know
thing,
what it
though,
is.
Man. Y'all know what it is.
Google. You know, we out here, man, making it happen, though, man. You know, getting this cheddar, man. Ain't nobody broke out here, man. We, our cheddar is good, man. We do big things, man. You better ask around, man. We do real big things, man. You know, we driving the fattest of whips, man. Foreign things, all the shit, man. You know what I mean? So trust that. Ain't nobody begging for nothing, man. We want what's
that's
ours,
negative, man.
Man. Them titles,
that's
they belong
negative,
to us, man.
Come on, man.
Ain't nothing, man.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
You better ask somebody about these Bay boys, man.
Why is that mountain bike still going bunker? This down miles on tech going bunker. Pull up in the light up in the new machine and bunker. Everything I do, I gotta do it bunker.
20,000 is change. 20,000 is what?
Walk up in the club, we in the going bunkers.
Talking on my pre-plan, looking for them free bands. Ran into my weak man, when I came back he was sleeping. I been in grind mode, pushing out that good. Rocking with some real ones from Field Mode to Kirkwood. My work good and I'm on call, young dog with big boy. Trapping on that interstate with plenty of peace and Barbie dolls. And this is what the game like, my hood got me trained right. Got it off in the same night with me and y'all on the same.
Come on, man, we gonna do this shit.
Let's say we've been the Bentley. You see how we pulling up, though? Hey, we call this salt and pepper right here, though. You hear me?
Opposites attract, man.
Hey, and then, like, look, Chaz, though, check this out. Then we go over here.
We got mix on the
and
floor.
And then we do the photo, you hear me? Salt and pepper.
Hey, we put in a lot of work, man. And now we back to the streets,
time.
Though. We back to the streets, giving back, though. You know what I mean? We just had a barbecue right down the street, man. A whole good turnout. It was all out of love, you know what I mean? Spent our own money.
We do all this shit, man, for our hood, man, for our community, man.
Was ill if you a dream or a nightmare? I dare rap about my real life. Good Lord, I gave my all, but this don't feel right. Jigaboo's a minstrel, you, but never me. Black face, my black face could never be. Sam Bo, my camos say otherwise. That revolution of mine, they'll never televise.
You know what I mean? Some of these dudes out here, man, we trying to be motivation, you know what I mean? To show them that they can do other things, you know what I mean? Because it's killers and drug dealers out here, man, and pimps and all the shit, right, man? We trying to change it up, you know what I mean? Switch it up right now, man, and, you know, motivate them on this boxing. Or whatever you got to be playing basketball, if you want to be a doctor, a nurse, a attorney or something, you know what I mean? I'm gonna try to put you on, you know what I mean?
Man, just be a champion that life, you did.
Ain't nobody no bullies out here. You know what I mean? We ain't with that, bully shit, you know what I mean?
Until I get in the ring. But other than that, man, we ain't with that. You know, we good, man. We good in the neighborhood. We good, you know, we keep it mafia, we keep it, you know what I mean, smooth. And shit, when we gotta get down, we just gotta get down. That's what's happening. That's what happened at the press conference, man. We pushed up on them squares.
They talking about, I don't know him. You don't know him. And you hugging up with him in the picture, man, you feel me? With an abrasion on your eye. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Your pops kept it real. Yeah, he was a sparring partner.
He didn't know he was a bum. He was a sparring partner. He was our sparring partner.
But he lied when he said he was a bum. You feel me? If he a bum, then fight the bum. Show him that he's a bum.
You hear you?
You know what I mean? That ain't gonna happen. You know what he gonna do? After we knock you out, he gonna get low. Like this. Hey. The field will get low, huh? That's what he gonna do.
On the attack, and this fight is over. On the attack, and this fight is over.
Hey, look.
Y'all Doberman,
hey, man. We pit bulls out here, though, man. You know what I mean? Pit bullies, man. You see what we rock with? You know what I mean?
Karim has snuck up on the competition, and he wants to be acknowledged. He wants to be recognized, and that's what he's doing. I don't think he's being disrespectful, but he wants to be recognized. So if he has to go into a press conference and get the recognition and tell the boxing world, hey, what about me? Let's give him his opportunity. He deserves it.